proudly present Once Upon a Mattress.
Thank you. suitable by the queen.
Are you ready for the next question?
That concerns me.
That's so.
Well then,
name three kings. King John, King Arthur, and King Edward.
That is absolutely correct.
She's the best one yet. Can I marry her now, Mama? Huh? Can I?
No, sweetheart. There is still one more question.
Oh, this test isn't going to be fair.
It's the law that isn't fair.
Throughout the land.
No one may wed.
Till dauntless, till the altar's land.
Till he gets married, none of us can.
Here is your final question. It is divided into four parts and concerns a famous knight often referred to as the Knight of the Red Cross. One.
St. George,
two the dragon, three well worth of teeth and or iron, and four, could you repeat the question please?
Four.
What was the middle name of the daughter-in-law of the best friend of the blacksmith that forged the sword that killed the beast?
As for the true brilliance of royalty, well, I'm afraid not. Remember, blood will tell, and yours didn't tell enough. So goodbye, good luck, and get out! Don't go still, and don't pout. It's nearly time for your cocoa.
It's just absurd.
I never heard a tale of the gods of hell. bargained for, if a new princess is not found in the next few months, then I will go out and find one myself. Oh, I don't deserve to wear my spurs.
Darling!
My love?
Do you remember the royal jousts on Whitsunday when you won those spurs?
Of course.
When you were called Sir Harry, the fairest and bravest knight in all the lands, and everyone agreed that you had a brilliant future ahead of you, that you might someday become either a chamberlain or even prime minister?
I don't know about prime minister.
Do you remember the picnic on the greensward with the lovely gold fairies?
Yes. Yes.
And there was a lark singing, and you said that you remember that moment forever because the lark's song reminded you of my name.
Yes. Larking! Yes!
And I watched the sun go down.
Yes.
Well, I'm having a baby.
Sometimes I get the feeling that you don't want me to get married.
Do you want you to get married? Do you want you to get married to a place? Don't you trust me?
Of course, Mama.
But then how could you say such a thing? I want you to get married. How many times have I said to you, I want you to get married? Just this morning I was saying to your father, I said, Sextimus, I want that boy to get married after all he is the prince. Of course, he didn't say anything. He never does, but you know him just as well as I do. I don't have to tell you how impossible he is. He may be a mean, stupid, dreadful, selfish, rotten man, but he's your father. And I want you to respect it. After all, there is only one person who cares about you and your future. And that's what you're talking about right now. Your future. I want you to get married. But I don't want you to marry just anyone. You must marry someone suitable. Someone who's good enough and nice enough and sweet enough. Oh my good, nice, sweet, beautiful baby boy. And she has to be a princess. A real, genuine, verified princess just as I was. And that's what you really want, you see? Someone just like me. Oh, of course you do.
Your Majesty, Your Highness.
Hello, Harry!
Don't interrupt.
Sir Harry wishes to speak, Your Majesty.
Well,
Your Majesty, I have the honor to request a perilous labor. I wish to go and find a true princess of the royal blood, one that will suit both Your Majesty and Prince Douglas.
No.
Mama!
No, 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 we begin with all the eligible girls of all the neighboring kingdoms. There are none. We'll simply have to wait till the little sisters grow up, and that will take years.
But, Your Majesty, I plan to head north over the mountains. Across the Badlands.
Across the Badlands.
And into the marsh where the beautiful swamp lily grows.
Into the marsh? Are you out of your mind?
Let him go, Mama, let him go.
You won't find him. Frogs and tadpoles and eggs, and do you know whether there is
Mama, life
up, down, and far, and quiet, and human, and the proximities?
Let Sir Harry try. Please, for me, Mama,
All right.
Hooray!
But it's your time. Come along, Dolphins. You missed your cocoa.
Good luck, Harry! Good luck!
Wasn't even more.
Can't you guess that it's confident error?
that you are a true princess of royal blood, and that I am actually to understand that you have the nerve and the gall to ask for my son's hand in marriage.
Mama, may I say something?
So you're the one, I guess.
Sure, I'm Prince Dauntless, the drab. No! Please don't go. I like you. Everybody does. almost everybody.
Thomas, I'd like to stay, but I wouldn't want to get between you and your mother. So I guess I'll just have to face the facts, cut my losses, and head back to the swamps.
Can I marry her now, Mama? Huh? Can I?
No. When you marry, if you marry, you'll marry a real princess.
Lost.
from every couch, pen, and princess that comes along. I am in no mood to sit for hours and rack my brain over a test form for that girl, but that's the way Dauntless wants it.
Oh, they seem to be in
our... And you know the worst of it? Is that that foolish boy actually seems to like the girl. So we must think of a text that looks fair and sounds fair and seems fair and isn't fair.
Well, let me just get this test under my belt.
It certainly has been a pleasure meeting His Majesty. Well, I certainly do like almost both your parents.
Well, we want you to be happy here. And we know it's a lot different from what you're used to.
It has been a little difficult adjusting to dry land and everything.
Well, you must feel like a fish out of water.
As a matter of fact, I do. You see, where I come from, we don't have any dry lands. Well, some of the poor people do. But the nobility live right there in the swamps with all of our servants and pets.
Oh, do you have pets?
What?
Dogs?
Frogs.
I come from the land of the foggy, foggy dew.
Thank you. need you, Emily. They've already sent a cleaning girl. You're new here, aren't you?
Yes, I'm.
Well, just look at this mess. What will my gentle princess think of me? Can you know what it means to be lady in waiting to the blessed Winifred? Oh, I can't bear to see the delicate beauty of my royal mistress in such a messy place. Harry!
Your Highness!
Oh, get up. You know you don't have to go through the motions with me.
Say, I'm awfully sorry about swimming the boat. Hope I didn't make a bad impression.
Not at all, Your Highness.
Your Highness?
I see you've met my dear Lady Larkin.
You mean this is the little Larkin girl? Harry, she's beautiful! And a bundle of energy.
When I gaze upon that captivating face, I realize how poor my description must have been.
Sir Harry is not very good at describing people.
Well, you may not know how to describe him, but he sure knows how to pick him. Well, if you'll excuse me, I better be taking these to the fourth floor.
I've never been so humiliated in my entire life.
Thank you.
Flowers.